Okay guys, we have just finished our tools and we have done drawing and modeling our project. Let's see that now we are reaching this stage. Okay, I will go to the power plan. Let's say that we have done with all of these electrical objects and these spaces and these walls and everything. Now I'm going to explain something about the visibility graphs. Maybe you hear me many times mentioning that we have set of options named visibility graphs. Set of options enables us to hide, to unhide, to do whatsoever we want. But this visibility graphics set of options helps us to control what are the things that we are seeing in our drawings and how to see these objects, like the thickness of the lines, like the color of the objects, like if they are gray or they are dark or whatsoever. If you want to control these things, once you need this option, you can go or you can click the G, which is visibility graphics. Now you have this box. This place. Okay. If you access to this box, you have visibility graphics override for floor plan level 1. That means that all of these settings are working on this file, or sorry, this view. This view is the only view that is affected by these settings. So this box is a view specified option. File. Now we have model categories, annotation categories, analytical and imported files, filters and text. For today I care for model categories, annotation categories and river text. This will enable me to show how I am control the appearance of the objects under these three categories. If I am looking or if I am using the model category, that means I will control maybe walls, desks, cable frames for example, ceilings, lights, any 3D object, any physical 3D objects. Solid objects in reality that we are touching, that are the model category. Fine? If I am talking about the annotation category, so I'm talking about dimensions, about 2D lines, about the detail lines, about tags, about texts, about the objects that are not used in the real life. For example, we know that it's a class. But in reality, do we have anything which is a class? No. Why? But we have disks, screens, chains, whatsoever. These are the models. The text, which is class, is a class itself. It's under annotation category. Why? We are talking about rivet links. It's about the link model in your project. For us today, it's the structural model and the architectural model. So if I want to control the appearance of the link, so I have to access the visibility graphic and the rivet links, then I can start controlling my links. Why? Okay, let's see what I can do. I have some walls, so I will go to walls. W. Right? These are the first of all, if I uncheck this category and click apply, I will have all the walls of, like laying off in AutoCAD. Remember when you want to hide the layer of the interior walls in AutoCAD, you right click or you go to the layer manager, you click on the layer that you want and you turn it on. Fine? If you want to turn it on again, I can go through. And I have them.
That's a variable.
Yes. Now I have this plus sign. As I said, I will open this category. I have common edges, the edges of the wall. I have the hidden lines. If I have hidden lines, wall sweeps and reveals. I have something in the architecture, wall sweeps, name, sorry, sweeps. But you can even hide or show the subcategories. Maybe you don't want to hide all the walls. Maybe you already hiding the sweeps.
Different types of work.
No, that's something else. Visibility graphics. If you hide the walls, if you hide all the walls in the project. But only in this
If you maybe want to show them in red, okay, let's cancel this box. I will zoom in. Maybe I want these words to
show the number
to show a red line, a red cutting line, or maybe I want the hash to be blue. Why? All these overrides are coming from visibility graphics if they are only mean to be done in this view. If you want the whole words to act this way, you need to access to the type and to change it to the type. So all the type will look like this. But if you only doing that in this view, so it's an override, it's done from the visibility graphics. Let's go to words, and now I'm working on words because I have many words in this project. I will go to words, fine. If I'm looking here, I have projection or surface categories. So I have a projection, that's projection, pattern, transparency. What does that mean? That means if I'm cutting a section here, for example, I'm looking at that wall is under the projection surface. Fine, because I'm not cutting the wall. If I'm coming on this category, it's a cut category, so it's the thing that is being cut. Like the plan, all the walls. The section, this wall, and this wall, and this wall. And the ceiling, and the blah, blah, blah.
So what is section cutting? That's right.
And cut.
You are talking
about cut lines or patterns. It's about the things that are cut. Like the walls in section, or the walls in plan, the windows in plan in section. Anything being cut, it's about what? About cut category, or about cut lines and cut patterns. Let's say that I am changing the cut lines of the walls. So I will click on this line. I will click on override, line graphics. I have these properties of this line, the weight, the color, the pattern. I can change the weight. For example, I want it to be 5 points, let's take. I want it to be red, for example. I will click on red. And the pattern, let's keep it as is. I will click OK. Fine. I'm gonna click apply. Now if I click OK, I will zoom in. I have this line and this line red. And that's applied on all the walls when they happen. Fine. Let's go to visibility graphics again. So go to walls again, W. Now I want to override the pattern. I want the whole wall to be solid black hatch or solid blue hatch, whatever. I will click on override. I'm gonna click on color, make it blue for example. Okay. On pattern, I will choose one of the patterns that I want to show in this view. Maybe solid. Click OK, then click apply, then click OK. Now, why it does not appear here? Maybe the cut lane is higher, lower, or it's not being cut here. Fine. It's about where is the cut lane and what you are seeing in this plan. Let's go to visibility graphics again. Or let's choose something. Just a cut plane from selecting nothing, it's a full plan. You go to view range. Here you can adjust whatever you want. Let's make the units meters or millimeters. And this is the places. Now you understand why we use the visibility graphic. If we are changing the appearance of something to show it or to hide it, so we are going to access the visibility graphic. If that's and only in this view. You saw that I have changed the walls. Let's draw a wall here.
This view means only in this view or in this
only area. In this view. Yes, if it's a section, only in the section. If it's a plan, only in this plan. If it's an elevation, sorry, it's only in this elevation. Fine?
It's only in section.
What? And not in plan section.
Plan section?
Plan section, yes, we are cutting the plan. We are cutting the section. The plan is cut, horizontal cut, and the section is a vertical cut. Fine. I want to change the end plate. Fine. Now, let's go to the graphics again. I want to go to floors, for example. I want the floors to be, to give me a pattern. Okay. Let's make it this pattern. Maybe it will not appear because it's very small, but I will try to show it. Green. Okay. One, I have selected the solid pattern, green pattern, and connected, okay, connected and right. It's not a green here because the hatch is affected by the scale. If I change the scale, it will appear. And maybe if I go to visibility graphic, now I want to use the rivet things. Under the rivet things, the option is now by positive. By positive view means that this thing will work the same way of the host. One, the electrical. I want a specific option under the rivet links. I will change this from by first view to cast. I have bilinked view. It will take the link options. I am having some visibility graphics or some object or some options for the appearance in the link file. It will take the link file view. And you have to select which view to take. Now I will not talk about this because it needs many things to be done in the link file. I will go to custom. Fine. Now in the categories of the link file, you have also model categories, annotation categories, and analytical model, and imported categories. Imported categories is about if you are importing maybe some AutoCAD files. Fine. I will not talk about this now. I will go to model categories. I want to change the model category of the link model. It's like I have opened the link model and I'm now working in the link model. I will change from by host to custom again. Now I can work. Let's go to host for example.
Should we need to make custom?
Huh?
Should we need to make custom there?
Yes, you have to make it custom. So you can change this to custom and make your options. I will make it again. Maybe red. And I will choose. And I can choose the lines, patterns, apply, and fine. That's the way of changing any visibility graphics options in your file. And that's about the visibility graphics. It's a brief about the visibility graphics. You can use it when you need, and it's only working in the view that you are currently working in. So if you are in a floor plan, so it will be a kick in. If you are in a section, you are changing the section. Fine. That's about the visibility graphics, and that's very important so you can make a proper presentation of your plans, sections, and elevations.
If you need to show a bar itself, go to Simply Graphics and pick the bar itself and apply OK.
If you want to show something, furniture. Yes, if you want to show the furniture in your plan, if the furniture is hidden, you have to go and show your model. By the way, keep in mind that you have a temporary height, you have a permanent height, and you have a visibility graphic height. What is that? Visibility graphic, now we know. VG, and you can access to this box and choose what to show and what to hide. Sometimes, while you are working, you need to hide this object temporarily. You want to make it a temporary height. You go, you select this object, and then you go to this access panel, or this toolbar here. You see this small sunglasses? You can click on. If it's temporary, you can hide it from here. And once you finish the edits that you are doing, you can redo, you can show. You click on hide now, you have this border. This means that you are temporarily hide or isolate this object. If you click on this tool again and reset the temporary height or isolate, you will find this.
Or you make the coordination sometimes is useful for making higher CC and.
Yes, you are right. And now you can click on the object, right click, and hide it from the view. Hide it from the view, it means that it's permanently hide. If you want to show it again, these focus guys, you want to show this again, you can click on this small bulb
Now the border is pink. That means that you are under the newly hidden objects field. You can click on the hidden object and then click on unhide element. Now it's shown again in the view. So you have three options to hide or show this object. You can select the object, right click, hide in view. You can select the object. This option is on class. You can click on hide element or hide category, isolate object or isolate category, and you know what is hide isolation. In AutoCAD, same way. And you have the third object under visibility graphics. So if you lost any of your objects, you have to check these three spaces. Fine? If you have any border around your screen, it means you have a temporary object. If you have it in pink, so you are under the 3D objects, hidden objects. If you have it blue, so you have a hidden or isolation or isolated sorry object. Fine? If you don't have this border, just try the fun. If you don't have any hidden object, you can go to visibility. If you don't find the object under these three options, sorry, so it's deleted or it's moved or something. Why?
We can make work search too from the location.
What?
Work search.
I'm not talking about work search now, so I will talk about when I talk about the work sets, I will tell you how to show the work set, how to close the work set.
Yeah. Same like this
here. Yes. And it's also similar to the isolation in AutoCAD. Fine? Thank you guys.
Okay, I will turn off the recording program.